Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's get a general and basic overview on the newest Studio One 4 by Presonus. Leave us tips and suggestions below this video to improve our next video tutorials dedicated to Studio One. Presonus Studio One is a professional digital audio workstation software used to realize songs and compositions with advanced tools, features, and effects to adjust and edit audio as you like most. In this video, we will show everything you need to know to start as a beginner with the professional version of this software. If you use another, you may find some differences in the features and the tools available. When opening Studio One, the start page opens with everything you need to start. You can browse for your existing projects, include online accounts such as SoundCloud, or access to the latest news and tutorials from Presonus. On the left side, you find all your existing compositions made on Studio One, which are divided in songs and projects. A song is an independent composition made by several audio tracks or channels with different instruments, such as drums, beats, melodies, or vocals, in order to realize the output sound. A project is a full audio compilation made of multiple songs or audio samples. In this beginner tutorial video, we are going to see just the songs. To open an existing song or project, just click on it. In the top right corner, you can use the Start button to return to the previous page, the Song button to open and show the songs, and the Project button to show projects. You can use the down arrow next to these buttons to shuffle between the documents loaded. To start with a new song, just click on Create a New Song on the Start page and choose a ready template from the list on the left side. On the right, choose the song title, where to save it, and other options below such as sample rate, bit depth, and song length. To see how to use Studio One, we just start from an empty song and confirm with OK. At this point, the song workspace shows up with the main editing tools on top, the main player at the bottom, and several useful panels, collecting features, samples, and effects available. You can open and close these by using the buttons in the bottom right corner. The central part of the workspace is dedicated to the main timeline, where all your samples and instruments are imported and placed in time on independent tracks called channels. There are two main kinds of channels. The audio channels are dedicated to audio samples with a defined instrument and a rendered sound waveform. These show a waveform icon on the left. The instrumental or MIDI channels collect sequences of notes that can be composed and edited as you like. Their output sound is given by these notes and rendered by a chosen audio instrument called synthesizer. These channels show a keyboard icon on the left. Let's start importing and working with audio samples. To add audio samples, just click and drag these files from your computer into the main workspace or directly from the Browse panel under Files or Cloud. Once an audio sample is imported, a new audio channel is created on the workspace containing a single clip or event on it. This shows the sample name and its full audio waveform. When importing another sample, you can add it into a new audio channel or on the existing one as a new event. To check your song content in detail, you can hover over the timeline above and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. To play back and pause the song, use the player at the very bottom or your spacebar key. The time placement is represented by a white marker on the workspace and described through the timer at the bottom, measured in bars, beats, and ticks. You can also change its format in seconds by clicking on the bars below. This won't change the format of the timeline as well. This can be adjusted from Time Base at the top. Next to the timer, you can set the time signature under Timing to fix the number of beats per bar, and the tempo measured in beats per minute or BPM, which sets the conversion between beats and seconds. Check out our links in the video description to know more about the time signature and the tempo. Next to the tempo, you can click and drag on the volume bar to adjust the volume of the entire song. Just make sure to check the volume level from the decibel meter above. This should never get any red color or you risk distortion on the sound. To adjust the general options of your song, just click on the sample rate on the left side of the timer. Now, let's see how to edit audio events with the arrow tool. When you click on an event, you will select it, and this shows several nodes on it. Click and drag the central one to adjust volume, or use the nodes on the corners to add volume transitions. These increase or decrease the volume level in a smooth way, which can be set through the squared node in the middle. Moreover, if you double-click on the event, you will open the Edit panel at the bottom, showing the interested audio channel enlarged with a decibel meter on the left. Now, let's see how to work with MIDI channels and events. MIDI events can be imported from existing MIDI files or created from scratch on the workspace. To import ready MIDI files, just drag and drop these on the timeline from your computer or from the loop section inside the browse panel. At this point, a new instrument channel is created with a new event showing the notes just imported, which do not have any sound until a synthesizer is defined on the MIDI channel. To add sound to the MIDI channel content, open the instrument section of the browse panel and drag your favorite one on the MIDI channel. Whereas to compose a MIDI event from scratch, just import a synthesizer and create a new MIDI channel. Then, double-click on the channel to create a new event, and double-click on this to open the Edit panel. This time, the Edit panel shows a piano roll, used to add and modify the notes inside any MIDI event on the interested channel that is open. Click on the keyboard on the left to check out each note or row, and then, with the Paint tool enabled, click and drag on the piano roll to add the note and define its time duration. To remove notes, just click once on these. To change the synthesizer to use, just drop another on the MIDI channel. Moreover, you can also adjust several properties on each note or on the whole event selected by using the Paint tool right below the piano roll. As you define notes on the MIDI event, it can be useful to playback these in loop continuously. If you click and drag on the top line above the timeline, you create a loop region that selects a part of your song. Then, when enabling the Loop Active button, you will playback the selected region in loop. You can also render a MIDI event into an audio event by moving it into an audio channel, getting waveform and editing tools seen on samples. You can always turn it back into a MIDI event by placing it into a MIDI channel. This won't work with rendered audio samples imported. The tempo sets the speed rate of all the MIDI events in your song, since their notes are defined in bars and beats. So a higher tempo plays all the MIDI notes faster, but no audio events will be affected since audio waveforms are defined and rendered in time. Audio and instrumental channels have several options on the left side of the workspace. Use the M button to mute the whole track with its content, and the S button to play back the interested channel solo, muting all the others. To remove or duplicate the track, just right-click on its options. Let's see how to edit audio and MIDI events on the timeline with the arrow tool. To move an event, just click and drag it in time or in another track. To cut, copy, paste, or delete the event, just right-click on it. These modifications affect the entire event selected unless you define a part of it. If you hold down the Control key and click and drag on the event, you will select a limited part that will be affected when you cut, copy, or paste. In case you make a mistake, use Control and Z to undo your latest actions. To stretch or shorten an event in time, click and drag from its edges. This affects just the event duration rather than its content. The arrow tool can also be used to move, stretch, or shorten each MIDI note on the piano roll. To edit multiple events or notes in the same way, you have to select all of them before applying any modification. If you enable the arrow tool and click and drag on the workspace, you will create a selection area that selects all events touched. In addition, you can use the split tool to split events or notes in multiple pieces by clicking on these. For advanced modifications such as time stretch, transpose, and more, just right-click and go to Event and to the options below. The Mix or Mixer panel is also a very important panel to realize your song since it is used to equalize volume between all the audio or MIDI channels and add effects and adjustments to improve their output. Use the Mix button to open the Mix panel. This shows each audio or MIDI channel on the left and the main or master channel on the right, which represents the total output of your song. Each of these channels is complete with a dB meter, a volume bar, the mute and solo buttons, and the panning bar above to balance the volume between the left and the right stereo channels. Moreover, at the top of each channel, you have its input and output specified. For example, audio channels send their output directly to the main channel, whereas a MIDI channel has its own synthesizer as input and the main channel as output. You can change the synthesizer properties by clicking on its name here. To apply effects to channels, you have to use the inserts and the sends that show when clicking on the expand button. Inserts is used to apply effects directly on the channel selected, whereas sends is used to apply the effect on multiple channels. We won't see the sends in this beginner tutorial. You can find all the audio effects inside the effects section of the browse panel. Once you have chosen the right ones, just drag and drop these into the insert section of the interested channel. These effects affect the channel before it is sent to the main channel, and are applied from the top to the bottom in order. You can enable and disable each effect by using its blue button and edit its properties by double-clicking on it. To remove the effect, just right-click on it and go to Remove. Now, let's see how to export your work. First of all, create a loop region on the timeline, selecting the part of the song to export. Then go to Song, and then to Export Mixdown. Here, set the file name and where to save it under Location. Choose the file format and its settings under Format, and adjust other options with Export Range and Options. Thank you for watching this video. Check out our channel to discover more free video guides.